Dear children, how are you all? Hope you are all fine. This is the last chapter we are going to deal with, that is data structure. We had already discussed about the data structures like list, dictionary, that is having a different structure of data. In list, all the elements having subscript and index. In the dictionary, all the elements having its own key. In dictionary, we are having key value pair only. My dear children, in this module, we are going to deal with the data structure. It is a named group of data of different data type, which is stored in a specific way and can be processed as a single unit. The single unit means what? Name, the identifier. Like list, list name, tuple name, dictionary name, etc. A data structure has well-defined operations, behavior, and properties. Dear children, let us more discuss about the data structure and the data type. The data type defines the type of the value we can store and operation we can perform. For example, In the data type, we cannot store decimal values. We cannot multiply two string type values. It also specifies the amount of memory it will take. Whereas, a data structure is a physical implementation that clearly defines a way of storing, accessing, and manipulation of data stored in a data structure. Every data structure has a specific way of insertion and deletion, like stack work on LIFO. That is, all the operation will take from one end, that is top, whereas in queue works on FIFO, that is first in first out. LIFO means what? Last in first out. That is, in queue, the item inserted first will be removed first and new item will be always added to the end called, that is queue. In Python, we will use list as a data structure. What are the types of data structure? Data structure can be classified into two types, that is simple data structure and complex data structure. In simple data structure, these are built from primitive data types like integer, float, string, or boolean type. For example, linear, list, or array. Whereas in complex data structure, a simple data structure can be combined in various form to form more complex data structure. It is have two types, that is linear and non-linear. In linear, we are having stack, queue, and a linked list. Whereas in non-linear, we are having tree and graph. My dear children, in this session we are going to deal only with the queue and stack as a linear and single level data structure. Look at the diagram for representing all the data structure. Data structures are mainly classified into two, that are simple and complex. The simple means linear or array list. The complex means it is having again divided into two, that is linear and non-linear. The linear types are stack, queue, and linked list. The non-linear types are tree and graph. My dear children, we are only going to discuss with the stack and queue. Linear list arrays refers to the named list of finite numbers in N that are similar data elements. For each of the data elements can be accessed by its unique index or the subscript. Usually, the index begins with 0, 1 and 2. For example, if the list my list contains 10 elements, then the first element will be my list of 0. Second element will be my list of 1 and so on. Array can be single dimensional or multidimensional. In Python, arrays are implemented through list data type as a linear list through NumPy arrays. My dear children, you people are not going to discuss about NumPy arrays. If you want more expressions or more explanations in NumPy, please go through with the text of Commerce. Commerce students are studying about what is NumPy and what are the linear data structures in depth. Let me discuss about the stack at first. Allow insert and delete items from one end only called to top. It is like a stack works on LIFO principle, that is last in, first out. It means the item added in the list will be removed at first. Real life example is stack of plates, that is a plates arranged in a stack. So if we want to take the last plate, we need to remove from the first, like books, bangles. Then the next any example is, the computer based example is undo operation, function call, etc. What do you mean by queue? It allows insertion and deletion from different end, that is insertion from the rear end and the deletion from the front end. Queue works on FIFO principle, that is first in, first out principle. The item added first will be removed first. Real life example is queue of people for a ticket. Computer based example is keyboard typing, that is first in, first out. Similarly, printer. Then what do you mean by linked list? It is a dynamic data structure, that is the size of the linked list is not pre-known before the execution of the program. It takes memory as per requirement during runtime, and every item allocated dynamically will be known as node. So each node contains two parts, one is info and another is link. The info part holds or stores the actual data to store, like roll number, name, marks, etc. The link will hold the address of the next allocated node in the memory, creating chain of linked list. The singly linked list hold the address of the next node, and the last node will hold or point to the null, whereas doubly linked list hold the address of the next as well as previous node, allows both forward and backward movement. My dear children, at the online session, I will explain with a figure how the demonstration, how linked list is working in its own way. Then the next one is trees, or multi-level data structure. It is like a hierarchy, having hierarchical relationship among its elements called nodes. Topmost node is called root and bottommost nodes are called leaves. Each of the node holds the address of the nodes below it. Each node of the tree will hold the address of nodes below it. It will never contains a closed loop. A tree is like a hierarchical model, the root and the leaves. Operations on data structure. My dear children, we can perform all these operations in the data structure. We can insert a new data to a data structure. We can delete or remove a data element, that is existing element, from the data structure. We can search an element in a data structure. We can traverse through each and every element, that is processing all elements one by one in a data structure. We can sort a data structure either in ascending order or in descending order. We can merge, that is we can combine two similar data structure to form a new data structure. My dear children, once again I am repeating the operation, the insertion, deletion, searching, traversal, sorting and merging. Coming to the first one, linear list. A linear list data structure forms a sequence when elements of data linear structure are homogeneous and are represented in memory that by means of sequential memory location are called arrays. An array stores a list of finite number of homogeneous, that means similar type of data elements. When upper bound and lower bound of linear list are given, its size can be calculated as size of list is upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. My dear children, here I had given one example for the array elements, the linear list array elements 10 to 45, that is the values, exact values, that is the exact data or the actual data, and it is having the index like 0 to 6. So what is the size? 6 minus 0 plus 1, we will get 7 as the size of the list. I think you are all clear about what is data structure, what are its classification, and what is a linear list. The next module contains further discussions. Thank you.